your understanding of reefs comes from your backyard reef. Every reef scientist is influenced by the reefs that they have worked on. I'm influenced by Connie Lee Bay. Absolutely. I was a graduate student there, and then after I graduated, I was faculty there. I learned to drive boats there. I did my 1,000 dives there. I started measuring the spectral reflectances of corals and algae and other things, and learning statistics, and how do you spectrally discriminate between things. And we started going, oh my gosh, coral is distinct from everything else. I think that reef science lacks some important perspective. You know, it's the analogy we're missing the forest for the trees. That is, we're seeing bits of reef, or my reef and you're seeing your reef, and we're not seeing the whole. We're not getting the synoptic view, the big picture. And I really think that we're not. That is what coral, the mission, is about. We're going to survey whole reefs. And so I want to see how reefs relate to the environment. Actually answer that question that we posed back in the 90s. How pollution relates to coral cover. I want to see that. I actually want to see the graph. Coral is only going to see 3 to 4% of the world's reef area. And that's not even spread out across the world. That's only a few select regions. So we're missing a whole bunch of the world. If a satellite went up that could make the measurements that PRISM can make from the airplane, then I would be ecstatic, because there is a global reef survey, a true global reef survey.